the organizers, including Otis Crandall, who is absent, for accepting my contribution in this challenging session. The abundant data of prehistoric flint assemblages and the numerous studies made by the author allow the reassessment of the role and value of raw materials in the complexity of chipstone industries. Comparative and diachronic analysis of the assemblages reveal specific features, including raw material, which elucidate topics such as intra and inter-site relations, networks, social and symbolic messaging, and identity, including the distribution and use of particular raw materials in distinct cultural contexts suggest different values embodied in various raw materials. Thus, the raw materials became a hallmark of community lifestyle in a broader scale for intercommunity, local and supra-regional relations. Bulgarian prehistory offers abundant data of the specific use and social values of stone and flint raw materials. Thus, the early Neolithic chipstone industries of Karanovo I cultural alliance, part of a supra-regional technocomplex in the Balkans, are recognizable by formal toolkits made of so-called Balkan flint. For many years, my research has been concerned with the role of flint, including Balkan flint, in the Neolithization of the southeastern Europe, a conventional view of which is presented on the maps. First, it is important to consider the general chronological framework of the Holocene sequence in Bulgaria and the position of the Karanovo cultures in the eponymous tale. On the basis of the numerous flint assemblages studied by me, coming from key early Neolithic tales and flat sites, I distinguished and defined a category of formal toolkits made of a distinctive and aesthetically pleasant flint called Balkan flint. Typologically, these toolkits consist mostly of medium to long, regularly shaped blades, frequently with uni and bilateral semi-abrupt retouch, from marginal to high and steep, and sometimes with rounded and pointed ends. From a technological perspective, this industry reflects the application of indirect percussion punch technique. Pressure flaking with a bone stick was used for the high and steep retouches. Most of the artifacts of these toolkits possess macro and micro wear traces of use. One of the main characteristics of the formal tools is their use on sickle inserts, a typical micro wear complex, with typical micro wear complex, which were inserted obliquely in curved handles, thus forming the famous Karanovo type of sickles. At the regional scale, formal toolkits represent a diagnostic feature of the early Neolithic flint assemblages of the Karanovo I and II cultures in South Bulgaria, to which belong most of the sites mentioned above. They appear together with the other elements of the full Neolithic package of the Karanovo I culture, represent a hallmark of this culture together with white and red painted pottery, which is part of the so-called Karanovo I Starčevo Kriš-Kerviš cultural complex on the Balkans. The spatial distribution of artifacts made of Balkan flint is very extensive, and it is interesting to compare this with the distribution of another popular raw material in the Neolithic, obsidian in its Aegean Koine. The Balkan flint distribution system was one of the two major lithic exchange networks operating in southeastern Europe during the early Neolithic, which were symptomatic of interaction spheres and probably played a crucial role in the Neolithization of respective regions. Balkan flint artifacts have been reported from Neolithic Greece, Serbia, including Vojvodina, Romania, Macedonia, and Hungary. Of particular interest is the presence of artifacts of Balkan flint, formal tools, by the way, among some early Neolithic assemblages in Turkish Thrace, at Hoxha Çeşme and Taşagi Pınar sites. However, the most surprising find of Balkan flints is the formal toolkit repertoire from the site of Uygurlu in the island of Gyuceda or Imbrus, territories usually thought of as mediating the spread of Neolithization from northwestern Anatolia to the Balkans and subsequently to Europe. It is worth reiterating, the one of the most striking features of the early Neolithic formal toolkits is the uniform raw materials from which they were made. Yellow, honey, waxy color, white spotted high quality flint which is called in the literature pre-Balkan platform flint or simply Balkan flint. It was defined by the geologist Chavdar Nachev as Moesian flint hosted in Upper Cretaceous chalk and limestone in northern Bulgaria. Till recently, it was not clear if the Balkan flint came from one or more sources in the Moesian platform, and if so, where precisely these sources were located. 2-year survey and subsequent laboratory analysis were performed in the frame of a project initiated by the author, and in total, 55 sites, archaeological and geological, were visited and documented. Many raw material samples were collected for analysis, among with archaeological samples of Balkan flint from the main early Neolithic sites in Bulgaria. The principal Balkan flint outcrops discovered are located in the Nikopol-Pleven region in the south, in the north Bulgaria. LAICP AMS analysis of Balkan flint samples have revealed similarities in chemical composition between artifacts and raw materials, with a few exceptions, but also marked variations of the analyzed elements owing to the heterogeneity of the flint materials. From the micropetrography of Balkan flint artifacts and raw material, it was possible to distinguish their composition and to identify the host sediments as belonging to the Upper Cretaceous Mesdra formation. In my view, it is now better to use this term for identifying Balkan flint rather than the previously used but less precise term of Moesian flint. Our results were published in a detailed study with extensive supplementary information. The Chalcolithic period in Bulgaria is known for its numerous manifestations of substantial craft specialization, technological innovation, and hierarchical social organization and stratification. All these phenomena were and continue to be a matter of particular interest for specialists in prehistory, and in this context, the Varna cemetery is the best social arena available. Typical examples of high technological skill are the extra long or so-called superblades over 25 cm long, found mainly in mortuary contexts as burial goods, and hordes or cachet coming from domestic context and interpreted as reserves of precious items for future use. In the chronoarchaeological sequence of Bulgaria, the Chalcolithic goes back to the 5th millennium KBC. It is necessary also to point out the sites, including in the presentations. There are 3 cemeteries on the Balkan Sea, Durankulak, Varna and Kozareva, and 3 tells in northern Bulgaria, Sushina, Smjadovo and Hotnica. Superblade technology is one of the most challenging problems of the current research, flint research agenda. The emergence and spread of this technological phenomenon is still unclear, but without doubt, the best examples of superblades derived from the Varna cemetery, including the longest blade ever found, 43 cm long, deposited in Barrel 1. According to Jacques Pellegrin and Laurence Manolakaki studies, 3 methods of debitage are tested among the blades from the Varna cemetery: indirect percussion for large-scale domestic manufacture, standing pressure with a long punch device or crutch for the elegant thin long blades, and lever pressure with a copper-pointed pressure stick for superblades more than 35 cm long. Inevitably, the superblades evoke a question about raw material allowing such a sophisticated core preparation and debitage technique. According to the results of the geological studies conducted by Chavdar Nachev, the best quality flint in Bulgaria among 4 distinct geological horizons, which was extremely used in prehistoric times, is located in the Ludogorie area in low Cretaceous Aption limestones and called Ludogorie or Dobruja flint. Its excellent petrographic properties determined its use for general large-scale domestic needs as well as for the most elaborate manufacture of extra-long superblades for ritual purposes in the funerary domain. On the basis of thin section observations, Nachev described 2 main flint types, Ravno and Kriva Reka. In the context of the mentioned above project, 31 new representative flint samples 12 raw materials and 19 artifacts were selected for petrographical analysis and geochemistry by LAICPMS, and apart from both known types of flint, a third one was identified only among the raw material samples. Both Ravno and Kriverika flints possess favorable properties for lamellar production, which determined their use in the large-scale subsistence and household activities during the Chalcolithic period. As for the production of superblades, unavoidably the Ravno type of flint was preferentially used because of its large nodules, extremely fine and smooth fracture, and last but not least, its aesthetical features, yellow-brown in color, opaque, with concentric zonal structure and or whitish amorphous spots. A distinctive feature is the thin white silica carbonate cortex. There are several Ravno types outcrops located in the vicinity of Tetovo, Ravno, Kamenovo, Topči and Kubrat in northeastern Bulgaria. The distribution of Ludogorie flint during the Chalcolithic is well documented beyond present-day Bulgaria, in northern Greece, Moldavia, Romania and Ukraine. Exceptionally large flint nodules, about 60 cm, were needed for primary napping and core manufacture, and there is an area in northeast Bulgaria, the Ravno-Kamenovo complex, which was studied and defined by Orasman Lokakis as a very extensive workshop revealing a complete chain of repertoire from the acquisition of large flint nodules in Ravno secondary deposits through core manufacturing, maintaining and exploitation using different removal techniques, including liver pressure, to the stage of tool fashioning. This is still the only known workshop in this scale identified by the abundance of core shaping artifacts, cores and debris, and by the large number of blanks and tools made of Ravno type flint. Let's look now briefly at some of the most spectacular finds of superblades, most of which have already been studied and published by the author. And it is worth emphasizing that none of the superblades has detectable use wear traces. I'll start with so-called hordes or cachet of long blades found during the excavations of Tell settlements, ergo in domestic context sensu lato, but without any direct relation with archaeological structures, houses, pits, etc. From Simeonovo Tell are several hordes of blades, mainly unretouched, many of them with pronounced profile curvature. Among them, there are a dozen that could be classified as superblades, but none of them possess utilization traces. A remarkable recent discovery of a hoard of 11 long blades come from Tell Sushina, from a trench lacking any archaeological features. All blades are made of Ravno flint. They belong together in terms of their morphometric parameters, but they are not direct refits. Here are the details of their length and technological characteristics. Most of them were removed by liver pressure, and none of them has been used. The most spectacular hoard of long blades, including superblades, was found at Tel Hotnica, again from an area devoid of archaeological features. Here you see their location and discovery in situ. Their morphometric characteristics point to more than one nucleus, and three refits have been made. Most of the blades were removed using liver pressure, but some of the buds and bulbs do not exclude the use of indirect percussion. As for their appearance in the mortuary domains, there are three cemeteries offering superblades as votive grave goods, emphasizing the high hierarchical status of the deceased. A Durankulak with 1,200 burials and a low chronological sequence from the late Neolithic to the final Copper Age, there are only three superblades belonging to the late Chalcolithic Varna culture. At the Varna cemetery, there are 10 superblades varying slightly in visual appearance due to the raw material specificity and the fact that some of them have ochre on the surface. It is noteworthy that some fragments of certain superblades were used after fragmentation, but none of the complete superblades has detectable utilization traces. Last, the most recent discovered cemetery near Kozareva Tel, where the excavations are still in progress, produced three blades, one of which is a superblade, detached by lever pressure and lacking used wire traces. To sum up, the hordes of artifacts in general represent a special category of finds, indicating particular attention was paid to these artifacts based on their real or anticipated values or on their anticipated future use. In any event, the hordes suggest they were considered precious by their owners. The Flint superblades from mortuary context reveal a separate sphere of their life. They bear symbolic value and votive function in ritual practices. Their purpose and function would be long and representative, entire and unused, as it was proposed by Laurence Manolakakis and confirmed by my user analysis. Take note.